Does your body need some work? At Morton Collision Center, our comprehensive professional auto repair services will restore your vehicle to its pre-accident condition quickly and affordably. Expert collision repair, undetectable color matching, free estimates, all insurance claims welcome, towing from the wreck with your request. Let the friendly staff at Morton Collision Center help you by dealing with the insurance company directly. Call 385-1048. That's 385-1048. We guarantee all of our work. Morton Collision Center.
Hi, I'm Robert from Richmond Hill, here to talk to you about Midway Family Dental. I went to see Dr. Jackson because his prices on dentures were the best I could find in the area. Their on-site lab made my dentures fit perfect. With their low prices, I could also afford to get the implants on my lower dentures, which they attached the same day. I feel like I have my natural teeth back and I can eat anything. And I do mean anything. Dr. Jackson and his team at Midway Family Dental are the best. Call them today and you won't be disappointed.
The helpful folks at Harris Ace Hardware say thank you for choosing Harris Ace as your favorite place to buy hardware and building supplies. Stop by Harris Ace Hardware and check out their weekly deals. Sign up for Ace Rewards and start earning points toward coupons and rewards. You'll even receive a $5 coupon just for signing up. Harris Ace Hardware in Jessup, Hinesville, Ulonia, and now in Brunswick. They are ready to serve your everyday building and hardware needs. Harris Ace Hardware.
Our customers comes first at First Franklin Financial. It's not just a slogan, it's the way we do business. Since 1941, we've been helping our friends and neighbors in the Southeast with their financial needs. We offer personal loans, bill consolidation loans, and more. So stop by our office today. We're conveniently located at 1074 North Macon Street, or give us a call at 912-427-4237. You can also start your application online at www.1ffc.com. All loan terms and applicable APR depends on meeting our underwriting and income criteria for the loan size requested and may require collateral. Georgia Residential Mortgage Licensee, number 5656.
When further treatment is no longer an option, hospice can provide services to manage symptoms and difficulties caused by illness. Emotional, psychosocial, and spiritual care, as well as support to the families and caregivers, are all part of hospice care. Hospice of South Georgia has been a part of the health community in Wayne and surrounding counties since 1998. The professional yet compassionate attention provided by our staff is unsurpassed. Widely supported by donations from the local population, Hospice of South Georgia is the local nonprofit hospice in Wayne County. Our administrative office is located at 1625 Sunset Boulevard, and Hospice of South Georgia accepts anyone who meets hospice criteria, regardless of their ability to pay. Please call 912-588-0080 to speak with someone about hospice care. That was 912-588-0080. We are your hometown hospice, and we are here to serve you. Hospice of South Georgia. Working to add life to your days.
Local news on WIFO.
It's time now for local East and local news. In the news, there's a new sheriff in town as challenger Chuck Mosley defeats incumbent Sheriff John Carter in Tuesday's runoff election. Here's a look at the totals with all 12 precincts and absentee ballots counted. Chuck Mosley totaled 2,002 votes to Carter's 1,976 for a difference of 226 votes between the two men. With the win, Chuck Mosley will now face Kevin Johnson, the Democratic candidate for sheriff in November. WIFO FM on hand at the probate office Tuesday night. Talked with both men. We'd be with last night's winner. Definitely the favorite to be Wayne County's next sheriff, Chuck Mosley.
Lord love him. And praise God. I'm telling you, that's what it was. The people just turned out that in my hometown of Scriven. God bless them. And I'm blessed. All the foundation my family laid before me. And the Lord looking out for me, I'm humbled.
Well, again, you got a few months before you take office. It'll be sometime in January, but now you can look forward to the race in November. You still have to win that race, but that should be a pretty easy feat.
Well, he's a formidable opponent, and I'll work against him too, but the Lord blessed me this far, and I won't quit working. I won't lay down. And I just want to thank the people of Wayne County. God bless them.
I'm sure both you and John just want to thank the people. One thing I saw today was kind of hot, you know, your volunteers that sit out there at the polling places with signs waving to people, both yours and John's. Just hats off to those people, because that's a tall task.
Well, I'm telling you, the people that volunteered, the people that spoke for me, that there's so many people other than me, it's not funny, and I'm humbled by it.
Are you surprised, or were you confident you're going to win?
I'm actually shocked. It was a miracle that I got in the runoff with John, and And the Lord carried it on through, and this is a miracle that I beat him. And I'm humbled.
Well, this is something you really wanted. I mean, yes. You talked about it all through the campaign, and it's something you had a dream to be the sheriff of Wayne County. So you're a couple months away from doing just that. So you got time to think about it. I'm sure you'd be getting your plan in action, your plan of action in order.
Yes. And I'll still be praying. May the Lord lead me. He didn't guide me wrong anywhere in this. And I appreciate you, Bob. Radio station, newspaper, the pilot that flew that plane the past two Saturdays. Just a bunch of people helped me, and I'm humbled.
Okay, well, again, congratulations. We'll look forward to the race in November.
God bless you.
And again, those comments of Chuck Mosley. Again, your winner last night in the Republican runoff. The city of Scriven, as Chuck mentioned, really turned out on Tuesday for him. As on Tuesday in Scriven, 303 people voted. Chuck Mosley received 248 of those 303 votes to John Carter's 55. Odom also went to Chuck Mosley. Mosley takes Odom Madrid Springs precinct. The total is 199 for Mosley, 185 for Carter, with 384 turning out to vote on Tuesday in that precinct. We'll look at the other breakdown of the precincts tomorrow here on the local news. We had a chance to talk with the incumbent John Carter after last night's totals, and he had these comments.
Sheriff John Carter, tough turnout tonight for you, lost by 226 votes. Your thoughts on the outcome?
Well, first of all, I thank my Lord and Savior, as I always do. He's got something else in mind for me. He was able to get his people back out, and I wasn't, and that's what you have to do in runoffs.
And we say all the time, it's all about turnout. Again, we'd say every vote counts. Pretty close race, 226. Can we say it all week long? The turnout kind of low in Wayne County. Not sure if it's the pandemic or what it was, but with 30,000 people in Wayne County, only 16,000 registered voters, about 3,000 decide the outcome of a sheriff's race.
It is, and it's awful. Even, if you remember in 2016, even the presidential race, as important it was, we didn't have but about half our registered voters turn out for that. I hope we do better in November. But it'll give me more time to go fishing and do the things I want to do. So I just got retired a little earlier than I wanted to. But, I'll just move on with my life, and God has something else for me to do.
Well, you're still in office till December. I was going to ask you, though, what your plans are after you get out of office. And you just mentioned that, more fishing, more hunting, more time with the family.
Yeah, that's what I had planned to do after, if I got to this last term. That's what I was going to do anyway at the end of that term. But I wish Chuck all the best. I wish Wayne County the best under him. And, we'll go from there.
You've got to buy your golf game. More time for your golf game.
Well, I'll have to get that started back up, too. I haven't been able to play since about 2004. So.
Okay. Well, again, we appreciate your time with us. And, again, best of luck the rest of the year in your term.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
And once again, those comments can come in. John Carter, again, 3 terms as sheriff. Again, he'll finish out 12 years in the end of the year. Once more, the totals last night in the sheriff's runoff, Chuck Mosley, 2,202 votes to Sheriff Carter's 1,976. Again, the difference, 226 votes. In the Democratic runoff for First District Congress here in Wayne County, Joyce Marie Griggs received 258 votes to Lisa Rings, 155. The winner of this race now faces incumbent Buddy Carter, and the winner is Joyce Marie Griggs. She wins the Democratic nomination in the runoff bid, defeating Lisa Ring. The final vote count district-wide for Griggs, 15,904 votes for 55.9%. Lisa Ring tallied 12,559 votes for 44.1%. Joyce Griggs now will face incumbent Buddy Carter in November. Carter, the incumbent. Once again, Buddy Carter will join us tomorrow as our special guest on the Butch and Bob Show, talk about Joe Biden's VP choice and other topics in Washington and around the district. We'll come back, take a look at yesterday's school board meeting. Again, now the date of when school starts, how school starts, all up in limbo. We'll explain that when we come back after this word from our sponsor and other commercial messages. Stay tuned.
Change is one big thing you can count on. And as life changes, you can count on Altamaha Federal Credit Union to help keep you and your family's finances on solid ground. We'll help you keep more of what you earn and make the most of what you have. Visit us to see how we can guide you and your family towards financial success through all life's changes. Altamaha Federal Credit Union, Jessup, Litowisi, and Scriven. Visit us at altamaha.org. Insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
The summer clearance event with no payments for 90 days is rockin' and rollin'. At Woody Folsom Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram of Baxley. Rock solid vehicles like Truck of the Year for 19 and 20. That's Ram for you. Remaining 19 Ram 1500 Classics are rolling out of here at up to 20% off MSRP. Rock and roll, baby. Get you some 0 for 72 financing through Chrysler Capital on 2020 Rams and nearly all Jeep models.
Don't forget our awesome free lifetime powertrain warranty. Good on most new and used vehicles you buy here. Good for as long as you own that vehicle. Ain't nothing to it but to come on and do it.
Hey, special rebates for first responders and military. We show our thanks for your service to our country. Better get to Baxter where we're rocking and rolling and deep. This is Mama Folsom's baby boy, Woody.
Remaining 19 Ram 1500 Classics are rolling out of here at up to 20% off MSRP. Rock and roll, baby. Woody Folsom Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram of Baxley. Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details.
Better get to Baxley where Rams cost less.
When you have an accident, you, not the insurance company, chooses the body shop, and you only need one estimate. All you have to do is call Jerome Riles at B&C Collision Center in downtown Scriven to deal with the adjusters and insurance company. Whether it's a little ding or a major crash, that B&C Collision Center across from Wasden Cabinet Shop in Scriven, deal with the insurance company so you don't have to. Call them at 579-2274. That's 579-2274.
The Wayne County Board of Education met Tuesday in a work session, and once again the topic of reopening schools in Wayne County on the agenda, and once again another call meeting to take place next Tuesday as more decisions appears to be on the horizon that the August 24th date could be kicked down the road after Labor Day, September the 8th, or Wayne County could decide to go all virtual, or they could vote to stay with the plan of action, schools opening August 24th. School Superintendent Jay Brinson says the final call is their call, as all local school systems in the state of Georgia have been given the green light to have school this year any way they see fit, and the different ways are being conducted all across the state of Georgia. Currently, the plan for Wayne County was to have parents and students decide between attending school in person August 24th or to opt for virtual learning at home. That decision deadline was yesterday at 4 p.m., and at the board meeting yesterday, they did not budge on that deadline. So, again, parents and students had to make that decision yesterday by 4 p.m. But now the August 24th date is in question, attending school in person in question, as now there appears to be three options on the table with the board to meet at 6 p.m. next Tuesday to make the final call. Here is part of the discussion at Tuesday's meeting.
There is no, the state of Georgia is not taking the, you know, the national guidance. That's the first thing, all right? And so the state is basically said, the Department of Health is going to try to put, should put some metrics to whatever, low-level spread, moderate spread, substantial spread, and they decided not to. So it's totally up to the locals to decide when you're going totally virtual. You know, there are no metrics that are out there. There's three or four, you know, separate guidances you get. Are you going by the Department of Health? Are you going by CDC? Are you going by the governor's office? It depends what you're going by. So it's up to us to decide when we're going totally virtual.
Everybody's kind of passing the vote to the table.
I agree.
I guess the vote stops here.
That's correct.
So, like you said, we need to make that, you know, decision on what the levels are, when we're going to, like you say, decide to vote. You know, what number? What's the magic number? What's the magic percent? I know the CDC guideline says if it's 5% or above, that, you know, for that weekly spread, that you really shouldn't be in person. Now, we've got, what, there's 13 days left prior to that time and everything, so within the 13 days, it could be we may have a seven-day spread that drops to 2%. You know, so we can still go ahead and go. But in the event that we don't and we have another week or two that's at 20%, you know, I would like to see us allow Dr. Brinson to say, okay, either we're going to vote straight digital on the 24th, or we're going to wait for September 8th and just let him have those, you know, that leeway to do that without us having to meet again.
The discussion continued, and the board opted to meet a week from yesterday. They're going to meet next Tuesday at 6 p.m. to make decisions regarding the opening of school. Option one, stay the course with schools opening August 24th with the option of in-school attendance or virtual. Option two, move the start date to after Labor Day, September 8th, with the choice of attending school in person or virtual at the student and parents' disposal. Option three, no in-school attendance at all. Everyone begins the year with virtual learning. Once again, the final call to be made Tuesday, August 18th at 6 p.m. For now, the open houses have been pushed back to Thursday, August the 20th, originally planned for this Thursday. Once again, Reggie Burgess will join us this morning in the studio. He'll have more information on what's taking place, what decisions will be made. Tuesday is anyone's guess, as with the current pandemic numbers in Wayne County concern. Getting 11 deaths now in Wayne County, the latest figure from the Georgia Department of Public Health another week to sit back and watch the numbers, study the data in hopes of making what they feel was in the best interest of everyone concerned. And we'll continue to follow the story as it develops. But again, how Wayne County will start school, when Wayne County will start school, once again, a big question mark as the decision will now be made next Tuesday. We'll come back with some final notes from the board meeting after this word from our sponsor, the commercial messages. So please stay tuned.
Change is one big thing you can count on. And as life changes, you can count on Altamaha Federal Credit Union to help keep you and your family's finances on solid ground. We'll help you keep more of what you earn and make the most of what you have. Visit us to see how we can guide you and your family towards financial success through all life's changes. Altamaha Federal Credit Union, Jessup, Lutowisi, and Scriven. Visit us at altamaha.org. Insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
There's a giant right down the road.
I ain't no giant. I just give giant trade-ins for your car. Great big old giant size savings for you when you trade with us.
Better get to Baxley and trade with Woody Folsom Automotive, the GM Giant.
Take a giant step forward and test drive super new 2021 Tahoes and Yukon.
Employee pricing on GMC and Buick. And select 2020 Chevy vehicles for up to 15% off MSRP. 2020 Equinox, 0% for 84 months. And no payment for 120 days. Find new roads again. Talk to the Giant and you'll be a client. Giant size savings are yours. Check us online at WoodyFolsom.com or get on in here to the home of the free lifetime powertrain warranty. Good on most new and used vehicles you buy. Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details. Woody Folsom Automotive.
Yeah, baby, yeah.
The GM Giant.
I ain't no giant, but I am jolly.
Do you need a new lawnmower? If so, head to Knight Saw Company in Baxley. Choose from a large selection of name brand mowers. Knight Saw Company offers the best lawnmowers at the best prices anywhere. They also have in stock belts, batteries, and parts for all mowers, along with name brand trimmers, blowers, and hedge trimmers. For over 50 years, Wayne Countyans have been getting their power lawn equipment and parts from Knight. Knight Saw Company on the Jessup side of Baxley on Highway 341.
Final notes from the school board meeting on Tuesday. The board tabled a decision on their student drug testing vendor selection. After discussion, Chairman Nick Ellis said he simply wanted more time to study the offers from the various vendors. Board member Sharon Daniel wanted to use an out-of-town vendor, saying an in-town vendor would not be as anonymous as she would like. The problem is the out-of-town vendor bid was $10,000 more than the local vendor. Joe McPipkin in favor of using the local vendor. Board's portion, again, no decision made on that. They tabled that item. The board's portion of the recent county settlement with Altamaha Bluff, about $1 million. But the good news is the school system received their portion of the FLIPA money in time, which is $818,000. So they had their portion of the first payment and agreed to pay their share of the settlement. Board set a tentative millage rate at 17.963, down from last year's 18 mils. Has to be advertised in the paper a couple times before the final vote. And the CARES Act money for the school system in the neighborhood of $1.5 million, which is a grant that can be used for COVID-19 expenses, then reimbursed from the federal government. CFO R.J. Aldridge went over what the school system is using the money for. A lot of sanitation items, masks, and computer technology to allow Wayne County to go virtual if need be. Again, after an executive session, the following personnel approved last night. Certified recommendation, Angelina Bowen, Arthur Williams Middle School. Aaron Lamb, Arthur Williams Middle School. Cameron Martin, Wayne County High School. Jasmine Southwell, Arthur Williams Middle School. Certified resignations, Deanne McNair, Arthur Williams Middle School, Rita Ward, Arthur Williams Middle School, Tyler Ward, Arthur Williams Middle School, Ellen Wild, Wayne County High School. Classified recommendation, Christopher Barrow, maintenance, Laura Heron, James E. Bacon, parapro, Heather Lopez, Martha Ross Smith, parapro, Dixie Moger, James E. Bacon, parapro, Allison Moody, James E. Bacon, parapro, Karen Pye, James E. Bacon, nurse, Casey Thomas, Martha Ross Smith, parapro. Classified transfer, Marva Jernigan, Arthur Williams Middle School custodian, to Arthur Williams Middle School head custodian, Aline Kearns, Martha Buckham Middle School food service, to Wayne County High School food service, Marcus Schott, Arthur Williams Middle School head custodian, to Arthur Williams Middle School custodian. Classified resignations, Bruce Caldwell, transportation, Jennifer Foster, Arthur Williams Middle School food service, Amy Mallory, Jessup Elementary parapro, and Darlene McBee, Arthur Williams Middle School food service. That's a look at your school board meeting from Tuesday. That's a look at the news here on a Tuesday. Sports comes your way in a few minutes. Bob Morgan saying have a great day.
You've been listening to local news on WIFO.
At 20
Folsom Ford Baxley. The question is not how are your Super Duties configured. The question is, how do you want your new Ford Super Duty configured? Hey, during the Ford Summer Sales Event, we're knocking ourselves out to make it happen for you the way you want it. Over 130 Super Duties in stock. F2, 3, 4, and 550s. Ready to go to work for you and with you. Gas or diesel, flatbed, standard bed, service bodies, cab and chassis. Whatever you want.
But wait, if you're thinking F-150, we have over 200 to choose from. With 0% for 72 months Ford financing. Ain't nothing to it but to do it.
Save, baby, save at Woody Folsom Ford. Better get in the back to you and ask about that free lifetime powertrain warranty. Good as long as you own the vehicle. Bring your mom and them and let's all have a good time.
Woody Folsom Ford Baxley, where we'll figure out the configuration you want.
Yay!
For all your medical needs, Tim's Home Medical on South 1st Street in Jessup has you covered. Oxygen, CPAP equipment, wheelchairs, walkers, hospital beds, plus specialty medical equipment from a local company that cares. Tim's Home Medical can handle Medicare, Medicaid, and private insurance billing, as well as family records for tax purposes. Tim's Home Medical, owned and operated by Tim Sloan, 918 South 1st Street in Jessup. Tim's Home Medical. Call 385-2490, 385-2490.
Okay, this is Herschel Hires, Chairman of the Board of Commissioners of Wayne County. The city and county government agencies of Wayne County would like to make you aware that all residents and visitors are strongly encouraged to wear face coverings as practicable while outside their homes or places of residence, except when eating, drinking, or exercising outdoors. Thank you for doing your part to keep Wayne County as safe and healthy as possible.
South Georgia weather.
Here's your WIFO forecast. There's a chance of showers, slight chance of thunder early. Then mostly sunny skies, look for a west wind becoming southerly, and showers and thunderstorms becoming likely this afternoon, low 90s. Heat index up to the danger level at 105. Tonight, 50% chance of showers and thunderstorms, low 70s. Tomorrow, showers and thunderstorms are likely high of 90. Georgia meteorologist John Weatherby in the GNN Weather Center.
Does your body need some work? At Morton Collision Center, our comprehensive professional auto repair services will restore your vehicle to its pre-accident condition quickly and affordably. Expert collision repair, undetectable color matching, free estimates, all insurance claims welcome, towing from the wreck with your request. Let the friendly staff at Morton Collision Center help you by dealing with the insurance company directly. Call 385-1048, that's 385-1048. We guarantee all of our work. Morton Collision Center.
Do you need a new lawnmower? If so, head to Knight Saw Company in Baxley. Choose from a large selection of name brand mowers. Knight Saw Company offers the best lawnmowers at the best prices anywhere. They also have in stock belts, batteries, and parts for all mowers, along with name brand trimmers, blowers, and hedge trimmers. For over 50 years, Wayne Countyans have been getting their power lawn equipment and parts from Knight's. Knight Saw Company on the Jessup side of Baxley on Highway 341. Tired of living in pain? If so, come to Smart Physical Therapy, located across from Dr. Hendricks behind the hospital. At Smart, we take pride in providing our patients with the one-on-one care that they need and deserve using advanced manual therapy techniques such as dry needling and manipulative therapy. Our compassionate and knowledgeable team can help you achieve the most optimal outcome. We will now be offering a free informational session every Friday from 12 until 2 on expectations following surgery. We'll be there one-on-one to answer any questions you may have. If you're looking to have surgery, give us a call to set up a free pre-op appointment. Remember, it's your choice where to go for your physical therapy needs, so choose Smart Physical Therapy. Our number is 559-2071. 559-2071. Again, 559-2071. Ask for Garrett Pye, Clayton Connors, or Nick Child. Smart Physical Therapy.
Since 1946, Murphy's Builder Supply has been serving the folks of Jessup, Wayne, and surrounding counties with quality products and knowledgeable service. Matter of fact, they feel they sell service first to make sure you get exactly what you need for your home improvement projects. And with each employee at Murphy's being there for 10 years or more, you know you're talking with someone with the experience to help you with building supplies, tools, paint, and all the things you need from a full-service hardware store. The best choice in home improvement is Murphy's Builder Supply, 156 Northeast Broad Street, Jessup.
There's a giant
right down the road.
I ain't no giant. I just give giant trade-ins for your car. Great big old giant size savings for you when you trade with us.
Better get to Baxley and trade with Woody Folsom Automotive, the GM giant.
Take a giant step forward and test drive super new 2021 Tahoes and Yukon.
Employee pricing on GMC and Buick. And select 2020 Chevy vehicles up to 15% off MSRP. 2020 Equinox, 0% for 84 months. And no payment for 120 days. Find new roads again. Talk to the giant and you'll be a client. Giant size savings are yours. Check us online at WoodyFolsom.com or get on in here to the home of the free lifetime powertrain warranty. Good on most new and used vehicles you buy. Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details. Woody Folsom Automotive.
Yeah, baby, yeah.
The GM giant.
I ain't no giant, but I am jolly.
WIFO-FM, Big Dog Country. It is time to check your birthdays and anniversaries. Brought to you this morning by Bondurant Power Sports.
Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy, happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, Mr. Kason Tire, the Big 11 today. We hope your day is fun and as exciting as you are. And that is Kason Tire 11 Love, Dad, Mom, and Hadley wishing Kason Tire happy 11th birthday today. Happy birthday to Mama and Nana. That is Suzanne Lee. We love you, Nancy, Stephen, Emma, Travis, Terry, Sydney, Ray, Peyton, Hannah, Jason, Julie, Madison, Caroline, Hayden, and Logan. Wishing Suzanne Lee, Mama and Nana, Susie, happy birthday today, Suzanne Lee. Happy birthday today to Ona Favaza. Also Deborah Jordan, Wanda Leach celebrating, Wanda Leach. Happy birthday, Michael Lucas, Sharon Mosley celebrating, Sharon Mosley, and Cameron Pye. Happy birthday from the Robin Eubank State Farm Gang this morning for Ona Fazava, Deborah Jordan, Wanda Leach, Michael Lucas, Sharon Mosley, and Cameron Pye. On this 12th day of August, happy birthday today to Dina Bennett and Sue Popple. Dina Bennett and Sue Popple, happy birthday from the Trapnels. For Dina Bennett and Sue Popple this morning. Michael Thomas is 19. Happy 19th birthday, Michael Thomas. Happy birthday, Mike. We love you. Love your family. Michael Thomas, 19 today. Happy 6th birthday to our son, Kason Struckoff. Kason Struckoff is 6. We love you to the moon and back. Love Daddy and Mommy. Kason Struckoff, 6. Also wishes for Kason this morning. Happy 6th birthday. Love all your uncles, aunts, and cousins. Kason Struckoff, 6 years old. Love you bunches, Grandma. Wishing Kason Struckoff's happy 6th birthday today. Kason Struckoff is 6. Long County calendar this morning on this 12th day of August is Patricia Morris. Patricia Morris, happy birthday. And in memory of Grady Mock, in memory of Grady Mock. So happy birthday, Patricia Morris, and in memory of Grady Mock. And that is your Long County calendar this morning. All right, you can textify this morning at 912-427-3711. Birthdays, anniversaries on WIFO brought to you this morning by Bartram Power Sports. Let's see what we have here this morning. Happy birthday, James Bunch. James Bunch from your friends at Country Corner. Wishing James Bunch happy birthday from your friends at Country Corner. Happy birthday, Jake Carter. Jake Carter, we love you. Jan, Kess, JT, and Kinley wishing Jake Carter happy birthday, Jake Carter, this morning. Please wish Casey Grantham, happy birthday today from your Oakland Baptist Church family and your youth Sunday school class for Casey Grantham. Casey Grantham, happy birthday today. More wishes for James Bunch from Sheila, your children and grandchildren. James Bunch celebrating this morning. James Bunch, happy birthday from Sheila, your children and grandchildren. Via text at 912-427-3711. You've got time to shoot one in right now. Let's look at email one more time here. Don't see anything else here. Let me look at that. That one. I think I've covered all my bases, crossed my I's, and dotted my T's here. Birthdays, anniversaries on WIFO brought to you by Bartram Power Sports. Back with your Big Dog Country birthday cake winner, and we will do that right after this on WIFO.
Bartram Power Sports invites everyone to come visit their unbelievable new showroom on Highway 301 South in Jessup and on Highway 341 in Brunswick. They have a great selection of ATVs, golf carts, mowers, and more. Bartram Power Sports carries Arctic Cat four-wheelers and side-by-sides, the new popular Can-Am four-wheelers and side-by-sides, cruise carts, and Yamaha golf carts. Bartram has the full line of Kymco scooters. Don't forget Bartram Power
Power Sports offers a complete service department for all your service and repair needs. Stop by today and check out Bardron Power Sports, Highway 301 South in Jessup, and their new location on Highway 341 next to I-95 in Brunswick.
Your Big Dog Country birthday cake winner on this Wednesday. Happy 11th birthday to Kaysen Tire. Kaysen Tire picks up the cake from the Jessup Walmart Bakery. Certificate here at the station. You'll come by, you'll pick that up, head to Walmart and claim your prize. Bardron Power Sports, Brunswick, Jessup online, BardronPowerSports.com brings you birthdays and anniversaries. Wishing Kaysen Tire happy 11th birthday. Big Dog Country birthday cake winner this morning. Happy birthday, Layla Jarrell, or is that Jarrell, 13 today? Layla Jarrell is 13 today. We love you so much. Thank you for waking up with the Big Dog, WIFO-FM at 7:36, Bible Check Sports, State News from GNN, a look at your weather forecast, and so much more on a Wednesday morning here at the Big Dog.
Happy birthday.
Kaysen Tire is 11, winner from the Jessup Walmart Bakery and WIFO.
For all your medical needs, Tim's Home Medical on South 1st Street in Jessup has you covered. Oxygen, CPAP equipment, wheelchairs, walkers, hospital beds, plus specialty medical equipment from a local company that cares. Tim's Home Medical can have...